exhibitions are still a thing. So a lot of stuff is going on here, very crowded booth. We are happy that it's that way. And we think that one of the main reasons is because we have amazing automation technology and especially the MX system. But before we go into that, Kai, thank you for joining us. If you are looking at a traditional control cabinet, what do you think, what would be the efforts to do the schematics for such a control cabinet?
Yeah, first of all, thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure.
To answer your question straight, it depends.
Yeah, that's the best engineering answer.
Exactly. It depends on the data you have, it depends on your skills, it depends maybe also on the system you are using. But let's have a look on the whole process of designing a control cabinet.
So it's more than the schematics, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Everybody knows the multi-line drawings represents the single connections in the cabinet.
Yeah.
But when we think further, the cabinet needs to build. What does it mean? We need to make a panel layout, the arrangement of the components. Everything needs to fit in the enclosure. The next step, when you have everything in, all the components have heat lost. That means you need to make a calculation if you maybe need an air conditioner, because it's a closed system.
Yeah, that's true also.
And on the end, somebody needs to build the panel. You need to deliver a documentation to your workshop that people can wire it, have drilling patterns, and so on. So you see, it's a lot of work to finalize electrical engineering for such a cabinet.
Ah, okay, many different things to be considered, otherwise it's not working at the end. Do you have a kind of a philosophy? Do you arrange by color, by function? How would you do that?
Yeah, color is maybe not the best example, but...
It's also mixed up here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the traditional way, I guess, and still many people work like this, is that you start with the power supply, with the income, so the big stuff. Then comes the power distribution, maybe the drives, the motors, and so on. And then we start with the lower stuff, the 24 volt or 48 volt, and the distribution of the control voltage. And finally, the IPC or PLCs and the IOs. This is the traditional way, but nowadays we have a standard for functional orientated engineering,
okay.
IEC 81346. This is functional orientated, and that means when you have a machine, you divide the machine into several modules, into several functions, and you represent also in the electrical drawing each function, if possible, on one or two pages, what makes it easier for us electrical designer and for the maintenance people.
So you are following with the electrical design, the actual machine design.
Yes.
Now, Kai, we have set this up a little bit. So this control cabinet represents a certain set of function, which is right behind you, represented by an MX system. So all of the functionality which we had in that control cabinet is also in here. How does this make your life as a planner, how does it make it easier?
Yeah, the MX system is designed according to this philosophy to divide a machine into modules and functions. That means each automation function, like drives, IOs, and so on, represents one module of the MX system. If you have a big machine, you can divide the machine into small modules and can use one base plate, place all the automation functions which are available on one base plate and mount this base plate on your machine. And for the drawings, it's the same. You have for each function maybe one page, and then it's much quicker.
So it's following the philosophies, your philosophies, and also the standards. It looks like the mechanical design and the electrical design are really going together. Yeah? They are one thing in the future.
Yeah, for people who make functional orientated design, this is the big wish that mechanical department and electrical department gets closer. But you know, that is a challenge for the next years. But yeah, finally, this is the way how we design on a modern way.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Kai, for having your look from an external perspective on the system. You will be on the booth today with us for a little bit.
Exactly.
I wish you a lot of fun doing that.